So I started thinking, what can I do? So that in order to change that violent in a way of living in a better situation. So I started thinking, what kind of work can I do to that structural violence that surrounded me? And that was my first thinking, and I was 18 years old. There were no peace studies in Latin America as such. As such, I am talking about the 80s. And so there doesn't exist, particularly because peace studies have not entered in the country with that name. And also you have to remember, because in the 70s and 80s, we have dictatorships in all the continent, from Central America to South America. So it was absolutely forbidden to talk and to study issues related to economical issues, sociology issues, violence, non-violence, human rights, and peace. So all these fields are considered forbidden, are considered dangerous by the dictatorships in all the countries. Of course, all of us know Gandhi School. I mean, it was a kind of lighthouse for us to read that was allowed. Gandhi was allowed because the dictatorships think that was a philosopher and it was in India. And so it is very, very far. And so it doesn't matter if we read or not, which means that they know nothing about Gandhi, as you can imagine. And also we connect this with the international organization, International Peace Bureau, that they have a very important campaign on disarmament. So we try to connect the idea of disarmament with the idea of the war toys, and said that we don't want to prepare the children for war. We don't want to think to make the children and the parents think that the only solution for violence is war or violent weapons. The solution for violence is dialogue, is understanding, is an empathy with the others, like Gandhi always said. So we have to work on this. So this non-violent toys campaign directed us to peace education and culture of peace education programs with local authorities and with Ministry of Education authorities. So democracy, understanding, freedom, new methodology, new themes are our basis in constructing a transformative education. That's it. Citizenship education is one of the main tools that we use. So we started to work on citizen education and citizenship education methodology in some countries in Latin America, like Chile, Argentina, Colombia, awful. Colombia, because they are in war. So Colombia is the Gaza Strip in Latin America, and Colombia is always war, so real war. In Mexico, that it is a very, very violent country as well. In Brazil, so we are starting in these countries working, the peace educators and the nonviolent educators, in trying to search for these tools. We also find, of course, that intercultural dialogue, intergenerational dialogue. It is, you understand, intergenerational. So the dialogue in between the old and the youth is important. We need a transformation, that we need a transformative education, that we need to change the structural violence in a friendly relationship. And so culture of peace education continues to be a need. And so if it is a need, here we are.